last video, we discussed about the criteria for the consistency of a system of simultaneous linear equations. Now, in this video, we are going to apply those conditions to check whether the following system of equations is consistent or inconsistent. Let's take up some questions. I'm taking for two unknowns only, two variables only, so that we can easily understand the criteria. We can reapply it to, we can extend it to three unknowns also. 2x plus 3y equal to 6, 4x plus 6y equal to 12. The system of equations in two unknowns can easily be verified with whether it is inconsistent or consistent using the conditions that we have learned. First, we have to write down the equation in the matrix form as Ax is equal to b. A here is a coefficient matrix containing all the coefficients. X is the matrix containing all the unknowns, x, y. B is the matrix containing the constants. We have to find out the determinant of the matrix A. You can easily find determinant of the matrix A is 2 into 6, 12, minus 4 into 3, 12. We find determinant is coming 0. So if determinant of the matrix is 0, that means A is a singular matrix. When A is a singular matrix, then we know from the previous criteria that we have discussed that either the system could be consistent or inconsistent. Can be consistent or inconsistent. And further, we also said, how do we determine whether it is consistent or inconsistent? For that, we have to calculate adjoint of A into matrix B. If system is consistent, then adjoint of A into B should be a null matrix. If system is inconsistent, then adjoint of A into B should be not equal to null matrix. So let's determine this case mein kya aa raha hai. Adjoint of A nikalte pehle. Let's find out the adjoint of A. To find out adjoint of A, let's we have the matrix here below. What is adjoint of A? It's the transpose of the cofactor matrix. Transpose of the matrix containing the cofactors of each element of the matrix A is what the adjoint of A is. An adjoint of a matrix of order 2 by 2 can be easily calculated without taking a transpose. So directly nikal sakte hain adjoint of the matrix of A of order 2. We have learned this in the previous classes. So to find out the adjoint of this matrix, we just interchange the diagonal elements and change the sign, reverse the sign of the off diagonal. This is the adjoint of the matrix A. After calculating the adjoint of the matrix A, we have to multiply adjoint of A with matrix B. Let's multiply adjoint of A, 6 minus 4 minus 3 2 column wise, with matrix B, 6, 12. What do we get? Let's see what do we get on multiplication. We get 6 into 6, 36. 36 minus 3 into 12, 36. 0. Okay. Check it. 36, 6 into 6, 36. Minus 36, 0. And further here also, minus 4 into 6, minus 24, plus 24, 0. So what are we getting? Null matrix. So adjoint of A into B is coming out as a null matrix, implying that the system is consistent. The given system of linear equations is consistent with infinitely many solutions. Abhi infinitely many solutions ka kya matlab hai? Matlab is system ke paas bahut se solutions hai. Infinitely many solutions. How can we find that out? Although the finding of the infinitely many solutions is not in the course, but for a better understanding, let's understand how to find it. It's only for understanding purpose. We have to only determine here consistency and inconsistency. So your answer should stop over here. But if you want to know what are the infinitely many solutions, let's solve it. So what was the equation? Equation was, as we call the equation was, 2x plus 3y equal to 6. Then 4x plus 6y equal to 12. Okay, this was the equation, and what are the infinitely many solutions here? What we do to find out the infinitely many solutions, as I told you before, again, I am going to tell you again, we are not interested in our course, we don't have to find out the infinitely many solutions. We only have to find solutions which are unique. If you can just see in the NCERT also, a note has been mentioned, only system of linear equations with unique solution has to be solved. Okay, infinitely many solutions अगर है तो ये understanding purpose के लिए हम देख लेते हैं कैसे find करते हैं. इसके लिए करते हैं x और y दो unknowns हैं यहाँ पे. Let's assume for the timing कोई एक unknown को हम कोई real number मान लेते हैं k. Y is any real number k. So corresponding to y as k, we can इन x फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन. तो हमने y को k अज्यूम कर लिया, y कोई भी रियल नंबर k है, उसे कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग x क्या आता है, 2x is equal to 6 minus 3k. Let's see x कितना आता है सॉल्व करने पे. तो we get x as 6 minus 3k upon 2. This value of x we substitute in the second equation. So y हमने k माना पहले, x की corresponding value निकाल ली k के terms में. We found out the value of x in terms of k. Now we'll put this value of x and y in the second equation to see whether the second equation is justified or not. So 4 times x कितना है, 6 minus 3k upon 2. Y कितना assume किया था, k equal to 12 आना चाहिए, चेक कर लेते हैं. Cancel 4 by 2. So what do we get? 2 into 6 12 minus 6k, bracket open करिए, 2 minus 2 into 6 12 minus 2 into 3k 6k plus 6k. What do we get? Second equation is justified. That means the solution that we assume, the y कोई भी real number है और x corresponding उसके x की value ये आ रही है. तो ये हो गए solutions infinitely many के लिए. यहाँ पे infinitely many कैसे हो गया, कोई k कोई भी real number लीजिए, corresponding x की value ये आएगी. मैंने k अगर 1 लिया, y को 1 लिया, मतलब मैंने k को 1 लिया, तो x क्या आएगा, 6 minus 3 by 2, it is 3 by 2. अगर मैंने k को 0 लिया, तो x कितना आएगा, 6 by 2, it is 3. That means as you vary k, you get the corresponding value of x also. So y के corresponding x की value आती जाएंगी, जैसे आपको k कोई भी real number लेते जाएंगे. तो इस तरह infinitely many solution हो जाएंगे. चलिए ये तो understanding purpose के लिए था, ये आपको नहीं करना है solve, और आपकी book में है, exercise में है भी नहीं कोई question इसमें. हमें खाली criteria चाहिए और checking करनी है system कब consistent है कब inconsistent है. तो वो आपको उतने काम करना है question number 1 to 6 में. अब एक question और लेते हैं, इसमें देखते हैं सिस्टम कंसिस्टेंट है या इनकंसिस्टेंट है. कंसिस्टेंट है तो यूनिक सॉल्यूशन के साथ है या इनफिनिटली मेनी सॉल्यूशन के साथ है. इनकंसिस्टेंट है तो नो सॉल्यूशन होना चाहिए. लेट्स लुक टेक अ वन क्वेश्चन नाउ. 3x minus 5y equal to 4. 9x minus 15y equal to 11. लेट्स टेक अप दिस इक्वेशन नाउ. दिस इक्वेशन वी हैव टू चेक whether it is consistent or inconsistent. This kind of questions you have in 4.6 question 1 to 6. So we find out matrix A. First of all, let's write down the equation in the matrix form Ax equal to B, where we know what is A. A matrix is a coefficient matrix containing all the coefficients 3, minus 5, 9, minus 15. And determinant of A nikalna hai hame. Determinant of A nikal lete. Maine x of B nahi likha. You understand what is x? X is the matrix containing all the unknowns. We can note down x is the matrix containing all the unknowns, and b is the matrix containing the constant of the constant matrix. It is constant, it is containing the constants of the equations. So let's find out determinant of A. Minus 45 of diagonal elements multiply by minus 45 are, but we take the difference of the two, the minus aega. So diagonal elements ke product liya, minus product of off diagonal liya. So 0 aa raha hai, check kar lijiye, minus 45 plus 45. And that means A singular matrix hai. So ya to solution consistent ho sakta hai system, ya to system inconsistent ho sakta hai. Determinant of A agar 0 hai system ki, to cases 2 ho sakte hai. Can split into 2 cases. Consistency with infinitely many solution ho sakta hai. Inconsistent with no solution. Uske liye kya karna hai, aapko ek aur work karna hai. Adjoint of A into matrix B nikalna hai. अब ये अगर null matrix आएगा तो system consistent है with infinitely many solutions. Let's check this out. और अगर null matrix नहीं आता, system is inconsistent with no solution. Let's check out. Adjoint of A निकालते हैं, बहुत easy है क्योंकि ये तो matrix A यहाँ पे order 2 की है, तो आप adjoint बहुत easily निकाल सकते हैं. Diagonal elements का interchange कर देते हैं. Let's interchange the diagonal elements. और product और off diagonal elements का sign reverse कर देते हैं. अब adjoint को multiply करते हैं matrix B से. So let's multiply adjoint of A by matrix B. We get minus 15, 5, minus 9, 3, multiplied by 4, 11. Let's see what do we get. Minus 15 into 4, minus 60. Minus 60 plus 55. Check करें कितना आता है, minus 60 plus 55. Minus 5 आता है, मतलब 0 नहीं आता है. Minus 36 plus 33. ये भी जीरो नहीं आता. So what does it mean? जीरो नहीं आ रहा है. matrix nahi aa raha, in other words. So you are not getting adjoint of A into B as a null matrix. As adjoint of A into B is not coming as null matrix in this case, therefore the system of equations here, this system of linear equations here, this system of linear equations is inconsistent with no solution. Inconsistent comes with no solution. Inconsistent having, that means having no solution. Now that's the answer. So from question 1 to 6, you can do, attempt all the questions from 1 to 6 on the same lines. And also there's a word problem, last word problem. If you can do it, try it today. Otherwise, I'll discuss the solution in the next video.